Welcome to this week's video. This week we're going to be following on from last week's video, and that is, should all charge points by law have contactless card payments? Now, before I get into the meat of the video, I make videos every single week about electric cars, and if you've been watching my channel for a while, then please subscribe if you haven't already. It's really important that if you subscribe, it helps my channel grow and it helps me get more content out there. So please go and click subscribe and click that notification bell as well. Now, I saw an interesting discussion on Facebook, and that is, should all chargers have contactless card payment? And in some respects, I completely agree that they should, and then in others, I don't. Let me explain two of my reasons behind both of these answers. Now, I think they should have it on because it's going to make things simpler for electric car drivers. It's one of the main barriers between charging quickly. It's the time it takes to load the app, and if you haven't got the app or the service of that company, you then have to register for it. Now, there is several companies all installing contactless card payments on their rapid chargers. For example, one is InstaVolt, Engenie, Polar are doing it on the new Ultra Rapid, so they're all starting to put contactless car payments, which is great. Which on Rapids, I think it's a must. I think every single Rapid should have contactless car payment. But I also think that the idea of having the app and also having them just an app on 22 kilowatt chargers and below is still much needed, and they shouldn't be forced in any way to put contactless car payments on these. And my reasons for that is, I understand commercial ventures and the way they work, and apps are a great way of collecting data, and that data is a great way of showing supermarkets the dwell time of how long you stay on a charger. So if they know that you're going to stay on that charger for a certain amount of time, they know that you're more likely to spend more money in their store while your car charges. They're giving you free electricity, but in exchange, you're spending money in their shop. And most people, electric car drivers, would rather stay in the warmth of the shop spending money than sit in the car in the cold waiting for it to charge. So obviously this is why I think Rapids need contactless car payment, because you want to be in and out very quickly, but on 22 kilowatt charges and below, it tends to be dwell times. So this app data is very, very important from a commercial standpoint. It's very important. The other plus point on this is, by fitting contactless car payments, you're making the machine a hell of a lot more expensive. Now, rapid chargers are expensive anyway, so the cost is dwarfed of fitting contactless car payment onto a rapid. It's a very, very small cost, so therefore it's not really noticeable in the grand scheme of things. But on 22 kilowatt chargers and below, then the cost of a contactless car payment is quite expensive in relation of what the actual inputting of the services is. So I do think that yes, we do need contactless car payments on every rapid, and I think yes, there should be a law forcing that all chargers over 22 kilowatt charge speeds should have contactless car payments as a must, as a government policy. But ones below, I fully agree that app usage should stay exactly as it is. It really does get more people to use the chargers, and more Tescos and stuff like that are more likely to start putting more in. Now, you're all going to disagree with me, and some people are going to agree with me. So leave a comment in the section below with what you think is the best alternative. Should they go all contactless car payment, or even an NFC chip to tap and stop charges? Let me know. I'm really interested on what you think on this. Now, I'm thinking of making some changes to my channel, and one of those changes is I'm thinking of introducing an extra video per week, maybe on a Wednesday or a Thursday, a live chat possibly with me every single week to discuss the last video. So people like yourself, fans, can ask me questions on what the subject is. So if it was this week's video, we'd be discussing live chat, what you thought of this, or we'd even do this video as a live chat on a follow-up to the app video. I might trial it, depending on what you all say in the comments below. Let me know if you think this is a good idea. By the way, don't forget to give this video a thumbs up. Don't forget to subscribe to my channel and check out my other videos down here. And consider becoming a Patreon. Thanks very much, and I'll see you again next week. Goodbye. Every woman's dream is a king and a queen. And I love seeing a little bit of bad on